Oh, hey, explorers, it's Justin again. Talking about population growth was getting me really hungry, so I'm out getting some carne asada tacos. And this got me thinking about globalization. Corn from these tortillas comes from the Americas. The steak comes from Europe and Asia. And these ingredients were combined in modern-day Mexico. Tacos are a blend of food products and cultures from different parts of the world. A perfect example of globalization. But for most of human history, this dish would not have been possible. There was a time when the only cultures and resources humans knew were the ones nearby. So how did these ingredients from different parts of the world come together? And how is this Mexican dish available in my city in the United States? It all comes back to one of our five themes, movement. Migration, or the movement of people, created the global connections that led to these delicious tacos. Today, we're going back to the beginning of human history to find out why humans migrated, what technology made migration possible, and the effects of this migration. Let's get into it. Our migration story goes back to the beginning of human history, when all human life started on one continent, Africa. The earliest modern humans evolved in East Africa up to 300,000 years ago. But these early humans didn't stay there forever. What do you think motivated them to migrate? Early migration was pretty straightforward. Our ancestors were hungry. Early humans relied on the plants, animals, and waterways around them for survival. These humans were also nomadic. When their food and water sources became scarce, they migrated to find more. This search for resources fueled the out-of-Africa migration over tens of thousands of years. Humans walked through Asia and Europe and took simple boats to places like Australia. Humans even walked to the Americas, crossing a land bridge that connected Asia and the Americas at a time when sea levels were lower. This early migration distributed human populations across nearly every continent, but a groundbreaking innovation changed how humans lived forever. What do you think that was? It's agriculture. Remember, agriculture allowed humans to settle in geographic sweet spots, places with good climate, soil, and access to water. This shift from a nomadic to agricultural lifestyle is called the Neolithic Revolution. It started in West Asia around 10,000 years ago and spread as growing populations needed more land for agricultural settlements. But as people migrated away from geographic sweet spots, they found that the climate, soil, and waterways became more difficult to work with. How did humans build agricultural settlements in less ideal geographies? Look at a couple innovations from the Neolithic Revolution and make some predictions. Wheeled carts and domesticated animals helped humans carry loads long distances during migration and work the land once they settled somewhere. And pottery helped humans store surplus food and water, allowing people to settle in areas less rich in resources. From these waves of migration, people created permanent settlements, populations grew, and our world's first civilizations formed. So, now there are people harvesting corn in the Americas and domesticating cows in Europe and Asia. But for tacos to exist, we need those ingredients to come together. How did these civilizations connect with each other? As civilizations grew in power and expanded their territories, they became empires. And as empires grew, so too did migration between them. Why was there so much migration between empires? Empires built their wealth by trading valuable items like silk, spices, and gold. And people needed trade routes to make this trading possible. Take a look at these technologies from the 15th century to see if you can predict how empires looked for new trade routes. Equipped with new technology like the compass, sturdier ships, and more accurate maps, navigators took to the seas in search of trade routes in an era called the Age of Exploration. Navigators from Europe eventually met Native American populations, which led to a wave of European colonization in the Americas. This colonization led to a movement of food, animals, humans, and diseases between continents we now call the Columbian Exchange. This global movement of goods improved the diets of populations worldwide. Before, people were limited to the food that grew in their region. But now, products from the Americas, like corn, could be mixed with products from Europe and Asia, like steak. This is how these ingredients came together to make the tacos I'm eating today. Meanwhile, the migration of people changed the demographic makeup of the Americas forever. Why do you think there was so much migration during the Columbian Exchange? Use this image to make predictions. European populations grew in the Americas as colonists from countries like England, France, and Spain migrated to populate growing colonies. But Native American populations declined significantly. European colonists brought diseases like smallpox that killed an estimated 90% of Native Americans. Those that remained fought to defend their sovereignty, but colonists forced Native Americans to migrate to make room for their growing colonies. European colonists also forced a mass migration of a different group of people, enslaved people from Africa. Millions of Africans were taken from their homes, enslaved, and forced to work in European colonies, which increased African populations in the Americas. But enslaved Africans maintained incredible strength during this forced migration, holding on to cultural traditions like food and music that eventually blended with European and Native American cultures. Remember jazz in New Orleans from Unit 1? That's just one innovation that came from this cultural blending. The Columbian Exchange led to a multicultural population in the Americas and laid the foundation for the worldwide movement of people and goods, a trademark of today's globalization. And yes, it made tacos possible. But our taco saga isn't finished just yet. We know that this dish was invented in modern day Mexico. I wonder how this dish reached the United States, where I live today. In the 18th and 19th centuries, a massive economic change triggered yet another wave of migration, the Industrial Revolution. You've learned about industrialization before. What do you think happened in the Industrial Revolution? Remember, industrialization means switching to an economy based on machine-produced goods. So in the Industrial Revolution, countries industrialized quickly and at a massive scale. The Industrial Revolution started in Great Britain and spread to Western Europe, the United States, and eventually the rest of the world. Why do you think the Industrial Revolution led to another massive wave of migration? Industrialization created lots of job opportunities in rapidly growing urban areas. This led to a wave of internal migration, or movement of people within a country, as people moved from rural to urban areas in search of work. And migration didn't just increase within countries, international migration between countries increased too. The United States, for example, was a rapidly industrializing country that became a destination for millions seeking work. The new technology of the time made this international migration more possible for everyday people. Steamships made long-distance sea travel faster and more affordable, and trains helped people move across long distances by land once they arrived. How did this wave of migration transform our planet into the globalized world we recognize today? Rural to urban migration developed urban centers into hubs of economic and cultural activity. Improved technology also brought global supply chains to the next level, as industrialized countries began to trade goods at a faster rate. And international migrants seeking work changed many countries into the diverse multinational states they are today. That's probably why there's a Mexican-American community in my city, and why this Mexican restaurant exists on this street today. So let's finally answer the question we started this lesson with. How do tacos tell a story of globalization? So besides just being delicious, these tacos tell a story of migration throughout human history. From migration out of Africa to spreading agriculture in the Neolithic Revolution to global movements of goods and people in the Columbian Exchange to international migration of the Industrial Revolution. All of these waves of migration contributed to a globalizing world and made it possible to eat this dish. And, of course, this is about way more than just tacos. Migration is responsible for all the diverse cultures and resources in our daily lives. It's clear migration has always been a part of our human history. That makes me wonder, is migration just as widespread and important in our world today? That sounds like a good topic for our next lesson. As for me, I'm finally gonna dig into these tacos. Until then, keep exploring. See you next time. Oh.